This is Marie Martins. She is the co-founder at Tallyforms. Along with her partner Philippe, they have two kids and they are growing Tally very, very fast.
What if we can, you know, make a fun form builder that is also free or at least very affordable and that has a different type of UX, and that's kind of how Tally was born.
To add to this, they only have 4 full-time staff members and are conquering it as a tiny team. I sat down with Marie to explore their apps, software, and most importantly, how they keep a tiny team operating with what software and tech stack they use, as well as looking about what life is like as a busy parent and leader. My first question, Marie, is around your routine and your habits. Do you have any routines or systems in place that keep you sane as a busy parent and a leader?
So I have kids, two small children, which is important for the story because that kind of defines how my morning and evening looks like. And I work together with Philip, who's a co-founder but also partner in life and the dad of my children. So we live together and we had to figure out the system of how are we going to make this work, you know, working together and having kids and trying to put in a lot of hours in the business. So a few years in, we developed this shift system, which basically it changes every other week. So 1 week you have the morning shift, the other week you have the evening shift, and then it changes back. So for example, today I have the morning shift this week, which basically means that I wake up at, let's say, 6:30, kind of just, I scroll my phone, which is a really bad habit, something I should really stop. And I just, because there's always, you know, like brand mentions or things being said about Tally online, or I check my emails, and that's kind of something I wanna stop. And this interview made me think about it actually. But so yeah, I get up, I take a shower, and then I take the kids out of bed. I have a 1-year-old son and a 4-year-old daughter. Prep them, feed them, and then take them to school and daycare. And then after that, I bike to work. And then I arrive in our office around 9. And so by doing that, Philip can just, in this week, just get up whenever he wants and already go to work and start earlier. Because then in the evening, for example, tonight I can work as long as I want, but then Philip will stop earlier, go pick up the kids, go put them in bed. So that's kind of the morning and evening shift ritual.
Are you enjoying this conversation with Marie? Snacks Premium unlocks even more insight, allowing you to go deeper with each interview, but also allowing you to see hundreds of other tech stacks, routines, and workflows to help you optimize your workday and get more done. So let's take a look at your app stack. I want to see what sort of apps that you use that keep you going across the day and keep you productive.
Notion as backbone for everything, and Slack. For me personally, I'm more active in the marketing, but also admin, finance part of the business. We use Canva quite a lot, Canva and Figma for designing. Octolens, I mentioned before, which is a tool that helps us track mentions of Tally or competitors or any other keywords that we want to track online and want to engage with. It's mostly Reddit conversations, tweets, you know, LinkedIn posts, anything like that. That's pretty crucial for us as well. Then I have Jitter. Jitter is a tool that helps you easily make animated videos or like animations for like, especially for not pros, you know, like if you don't have actual video editing skills, Jitter is pretty great. Opus Clip is a tool that you basically, if we make customer stories, we just record a whole interview, we drop in the video file, and it automatically generates snippets, short clips with subtitles, you know, using AI, that can help us to share the customer story on social media. So that's definitely a great one. And yeah, I probably forgot the most important one, which is ChatGPT. which I use for almost everything, research, writing, creative brainstorms. Like, it's just my personal assistant, always open. So I think that would be, it would be a pretty crucial one. And then for the product engineering side, Notion as well, but as well Cursor and CodeRabbit, just to help with AI code review. Those are pretty important for them. What else do we have? GitHub, of course. And then I guess Plausible we use for analytics. They're privacy-friendly analytics based in Europe. Google Cloud for backend infrastructure. Browser Stack for testing new features on different tools or browsers.
So one thing that Marie forgot there is that Tally is also an important part of Tally itself. It is a form building application and it's growing very, very fast as a company. You can also find that linked below.
I'm usually the most productive in the morning, I would say. So I try to tackle more creative projects or writing or anything like that in the morning, and then do more, you know, like admin and emails and following up and giving feedback in the afternoon. That's what I try to do. It doesn't always work like that, but that's kind of my setup. We don't have a lot of meetings or no recurring meetings, and I also tend to say no to everyone who reaches out and just wants to have, you know, a chat or a sales call or anything like that. So we're pretty ruthless with that. You know, we also only say yes to meetings that can actually be very interesting for Tally, or for example, you know, the chats or the interviews that we want to have. Yeah, that's basically it. That's kind of how the day evolves. It looks kind of different every day. There's not like super strict like blocks of focused work or anything like that. But that's kind of the flow of the day. We have lunch with the team and then I work as long as, you know, I have the energy or as long as I'm productive, and then go home. We have, you know, I have drinks with friends once in a while in the evening just to switch off. I also try to work out twice a week, and we do that in the gym here at work. So I try to combine all of that. It can be in the morning or it can be at lunchtime. Try to fit all of that in the day. But that's kind of how a typical day would look like.
So a big thanks to Marie for coming on here on Snacks. If you'd like to see more Snacks, you can jump over in the description below. You can also find all the apps that I mentioned below as well if you're interested in exploring her stack.